Okay, so in this tutorial for Final Cut Pro 10, we're going to have a look at how we scale and rotate clips. Now, this popped up today because I was working with someone who'd shot a video on their iPhone, and in the iPhone, it can shoot a video in portrait as well as landscape. We're going to look at how we get those back in to a regular landscape video format so that you're ready to edit with them. So let's dive into Final Cut Pro here and have a look at how we do this. Okay, so we're going to go ahead into Final Cut Pro, first of all, and we're going to set up a new project or a new sequence for our edit. So we're going to go to File, New, and Project, okay? And we're going to make a custom project just to kind of run through the different settings. So we're going to set it at 720p, high definition, 1280 by 720. Our footage is 1920 by 1080, so we're going to be scaling it down a little bit. And then our frame rate is going to be 30 frames per second. We use the default settings for the audio and rendering. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and set up this project. We'll just call it iPhone footage. So now we have our sequence set up, we're going to go ahead and bring our clip in. So here we have a video shot on an iPhone, and basically we're going to pull this in to our timeline. So we'll drag this straight down to our timeline and then jump back into Final Cut Pro. So now Final Cut Pro has automatically scaled our clip, and in order to rotate it and scale it accurately, we want to take that automatic scaling off. So if we highlight our clip here and come up to the video inspector, okay, if you don't see the video inspector, just go to Window, Show Inspector, which will be visible there, and then jump back to the inspector and scroll down. And there's this option called Spatial Conform, which is going to fit our video automatically. So it's scaling it down from its original format to a smaller size. So we're going to turn that to none. Okay. So now we know that when we're scaling it using the transform properties up here, we can type in some specific numbers to get it to scale and rotate properly. So I'm just going to highlight the zero there and type in minus 90. Okay, and that will rotate my clip by negative 90 degrees. And then for my scale, the relation of 1080p in relation to 720p is basically 66.67% of the original format. So I'm just going to highlight the 100% there and type in 66.67, and my clips will now be formatted. So you can see we can have it rotated as minus 90, or we can type in 90 here to rotate it the other way. So it just depends which way you want to alter that orientation. But you can see, because we've got this specific percentage in here, it's now scaled that nicely so that it fits perfectly within our video edit. Okay, so we'll keep it like this for the moment. So now we're going to go ahead and look at what happens if we have multiple clips that have this size and scale change that needs to be made. So I'm just going to go up here and grab the original clip a few times and just duplicate it on the timeline. Okay, so we have a feature in Final Cut Pro 10 that allows to copy and paste attributes to different clips. So this first clip is scaled, it's all ready to go, we've rotated it, and these other clips will now have the original settings that you get when you drag this portrait footage down to the timeline. So I want to copy the properties of this clip and paste them to the other clips. Okay, so I'm going to go to Edit and Copy, and then I'm going to select all these clips. Okay, just come across this second clip. So all these clips are in this portrait format. And then I'm going to go to Edit and Paste Attributes. Okay. So now I'm going to be able to paste the transform options, which is the rotation and the scale, importantly. Okay. I don't need the position and anchor, actually. And then I'm also going to paste the spatial conform as well, which is going to take off that automatic spatial conforming. Okay. So let's go ahead now and paste that. And you'll see now that those clips are all now in that correct format. Okay, so that's a great way of copying and pasting not just scale and rotation attributes, but also effects as well. So you can paste effects in the same way from one clip to another. So from one clip to your entire timeline, you can paste different attributes. So there's another way of dealing with these clips that have been shot in a portrait format. So I'm going to drag one of these original clips down. Okay, and the other way of kind of working with these is to do a split screen. So if I drag a few of these down as layers, okay, just make sure they're snapping together, then you can see now we can have three different layers with the same video on them. So I'm going to highlight the second layer, and I'm going to go up to my transform properties in the inspector here and just change the X position of that clip to pull it to the left here. And then I'll go ahead, highlight the top one and change the X position in the opposite direction for for this other clip. So you can see we can do a split screen here. Okay, and then if I highlight all these clips at the same time to fill in these black lines, I can then just scale them all up in one go. Okay, so now we have a nice split screen with no black lines in between that will work pretty well, especially if you have different clips that are running across these three panels that we've created here. Okay, so that's a couple of different ways of dealing with footage that's been shot in portrait on an iPhone, either by rotating it and getting it into the format of your original timeline, or by thinking about creating a split screen where you're offsetting the different clips. So I hope you found that useful. If you have any questions about Final Cut Pro 10, then please don't hesitate to leave me a message here, and I look forward to seeing you in the next tutorial.